Well, those look like a good set of numbers from CSB Bank. The net profits have gone up about 80-odd% or so. The net interest income as well. The stock is up almost about 4-odd%. The other income has gone up substantially, and there is a big recovery in their asset quality. So gross NPAs have fallen to 1.8% versus 3%. Yes, net NPAs have also fallen. Gross NPAs have also fallen quarter on quarter. I think that's what the street is reacting to. Stock up almost about 4.5% right now.
There was one Axis Cap poll, and that expected the NII at 248 crores. Net profit, they were expecting at 60 crores. I think it's beaten all ends up. Other income is very good. That's what most guys will report, because the yields are lower and bond prices are higher. But this is a big fall in gross NPA. You know, Catholic Syrian Bank or CSB is not your typical bank. It's got a lot of gold deposits. It's not the typical lending to MSME and lending to corporate sector, lending to infrastructure and having NPAs.
Yeah.
So we should not extrapolate CSB's earnings. At the most, it can be extrapolated to Muthoot and Manappuram as gold finance companies. It should not be extrapolated so much to the banking sector, but it's a good set of numbers coming in from CSB. Okay, and with that, it's time for our special offering.
The got the better of Lata, but let's talk about the quarter say quarter tak segment, where we take stock of expectations from various sectors. And today on our radar is the cement space. Nigel is here with a quick heads up on what to expect. Nigel, over to you.
Well, there was some easing in terms of these lockdown restrictions, and that's what helped cement demand in terms of movement as well as in terms of demand as well. For the industry on the whole, the growth was roughly around 6 to around 8% in the past quarter. That's the rough range that the street is working with out there. What grew well? Well, North and East India, we saw good growth out there. Though South India, that struggled a tad bit. In fact, in the South, we did have a bit of a degrowth, though prices as well as, EBITDA per ton will be very, very strong. What helps cement demand? One is that rural demand was strong. It continued to remain strong. The bigger part, though, is that we saw a big recovery in non-trade segment. That's the profitable segment. And that's what will help profitability in this quarter itself. Pricing, well, it's a little bit lower on a sequential basis. The pricing is down anything between around 2 to around 3%. Parts of India, West as well as East, we saw, some kind of pricing erosion out there. So for Pan-India, it'll be lower. Variable cost, though, could move up. Why? Pet coke prices. They average around $75-$80 per ton. They moved to around $100 per ton. So pet coke prices spiked up. That's what will hurt them a tad bit. And there were certain expenditures that were cut off in the first part of the year, like marketing, advertising and the likes. That will return in quarter three. But, that will be offset because operating leverage will play out, and there are other cost-cutting measures that the street is working with, and that's what will lead the EBITDA per ton to move higher. Operating leverage will hold them in good stead. Let's start off with a few companies then. UltraTech Cement, we're working with, volume growth out there of around 7%. These are Kotak estimates, but the EBITDA per ton, big jump out there, up closer around 4%, though on a sequential basis there'll be some shaving off, but that's par for the course. Shri Cement volumes will be good. Volumes will be nearly around 15% out there. They have additional capacity coming on stream. However, on a high base, the EBITDA per ton won't look that good. Likely to rise by closer on 5%. But the other couple of names like ACC as well as Ambuja Cements, both of them, volume growth doesn't come about because they're functioning at peak utilization levels. But what impresses is the EBITDA per ton. For both of them, will grow by nearly around 30 to around 32% odd. And Dalmia Cement, well, they've exposure to South India out there. Those numbers will look very, very good. In fact, that could be the pick of the pack from, the larger cement companies out there. EBITDA per ton will grow by close to around 35%, and volumes as well is likely to jump up by close to around 10%. Finally, in terms of valuations, yes, these stocks have had a big run. Shri Cement traded at peak valuations, continues to trade at peak valuation. So in terms of the average, it's more or less in line. But UltraTech Cement as well as ACC Ambuja, a little bit lower than what they've traded in the past. Even India Cements and Ramco Cements as well as Dalmia Cement, a bit lower in terms of valuations on an EV upon EBITDA in comparison to what they should normally trade at. Short point, it's going to be a very, very solid quarter. Back to you guys.
Okay, it'll be a solid quarter.
No, it'll be a very, very,
very, very solid. Not one very, two very. So we know the impact of the quarter, right? Naveen Sahadeo, the research analyst of Edelweiss, joins us now to talk about that. Naveen, you heard my colleague Nigel explain so well what the expectations are, but you tell us, what is your pick of the pack and what is the growth that you're expecting?
Right. So Nigel indeed summed up really well for us. Pick of the pack, I'll clearly go with Ambuja Cement in the large cap space. Clearly, because one, first and foremost, of course, along with the rest of the industry, here also you will see some very good earnings growth. I am expecting a 27-28% kind of a EBITDA growth a year on year. And sequentially also, it is going to inch up slightly by just about 2-3%. So definitely encouraging set of numbers is what I would expect. And importantly, Ambuja, with all the positive virtues that they are working with, be it on largely on the cost front, I think it still trades less than 11 times EV EBITDA compared to, let's say, a 13 times for Ultratech or even a 15-16 times for a premium player like Shree. So valuation comfort and robust earnings growth, I think a combination makes Ambuja my clear top pick from the result perspective. And in general, I'm very bullish on the stock.
Okay. Not speaking of price, Naveen, what would be the best performer? I thought Nigel was saying South-based companies would do the best.
On a year-on-year basis, yes. Because same time last year, the prices in South were extremely low. So if I compare point to point or quarter, same quarter last year, the average prices in South are up almost about 15-17%. So on a YOY basis, South would do better. But otherwise, I think by and large, even North and Center as a regions are expected to do fairly well in terms of prices.
Okay. Naveen, what are you hearing in terms of growth, say from cement dealers and even from your company sources? Is there a spring in the step, infra and rural housing or even urban housing picking up? Or is it like just one of those mediocre quarters?
No, not at all. Let me be very upfront about this, that, the demand feedback, not a single company or a dealer or any other channel check that we do has given a negative response. There could be volatility in prices and that feedback is there, but the demand feedback, even as recent as yesterday, I was speaking to some of the large dealers, the demand feedback continues to be very, very encouraging. And that's what I think is the most important parameter to be tracked, because if that is demand is in place, then your prices can also recover and your cost can also be passed on to the consumers. For the quarter, I'm expecting at least about 5% kind of a growth at the broader industry level, and with South being negative, as Nigel pointed, then rest of the regions are clearly looking at a very good higher single digit or a double digit kind of a growth. And even now, as in January for that matter also, the latest feedback is definitely good traction on demand is continuing. That should be very encouraging.
Okay, so from the large caps, you said Ambuja Cement is your pick of the pack. In the non-index large caps or the mid caps, I was just hearing Nigel tell us that compared to five-year average valuations, I think the only stock that still trades at a big discount is India Cements. It's trading at 7 times versus the five-year average at 11 times. You think valuation-wise, India Cements is attractive or do you like other stocks?
See, I have a reduced recommendation on India Cement because fundamentally nothing is really changing except for the buzz of some merger and acquisition, probably kind of a buzz on the street around that. So except for that, I don't think there is much really to cheer. The 6-7 times EV EBITDA seems attractive, but then they are very high on net debt to EBITDA and very low on ROEs. So it wouldn't be a very compelling pick for me unless it is very clear in terms of the other, like I said, M&A related issue. But other mid-caps point of view, I think clearly JK Cement looks to be an extremely, well-placed stock. We're expecting 40-45% EBITDA growth, and they have just completed expansions, which means at least 4-5 quarters of very robust EBITDA growth.
Okay. Well, two very quick questions, Naveen. One, why is not Ultratech in your list? Because in Nigel's comparison, it's still trading below its past five-year average, which was 16 times, and now it's in EV to EBITDA basis, 13 times. Secondly, is this CCI search, a CCI probe, a bit of a negative that will make them wary of raising prices?
So your first question, Ultratech, I have a positive rating on the stock. We have a buy recommendation, but since you asked which is the top pick, I mentioned Ambuja because for the same or better ROEs, for a lot of traction that is happening on the cost front and the valuation, which is at least 10 to 15% lower than an UltraTech, Ambuja makes a clear favorite ahead of UltraTech for me. Nonetheless, UltraTech is also a positive pick in that sense. Answering CCI. Your second question, CCI, yes. Mm-hmm. So CCI, I initially, like, you know, even I was like, you know, we were getting this feedback that there is some bit of a overhang, and in general, typically around this Makar Sankranti festival, there is, given that it's the beginning of the busy season and there should be a reasonable amount of price hike or that buzz around that, that was missing. It seemed disappointing initially. But like I said, as recent, the channel checks that we have done in the last just a couple of days makes us believe that with the demand that is gaining pace, there is every reason that there will be price hike. And my point broadly is that even a 5 to 10 rupee price hike, which is convincing and it sticks around, can throw out the CCI overhang in no time. I mean, there is a perceived CCI overhang in the investor community for sure, but a 10 rupee price hike, I'm saying, can get that overhang out.
All right.
And I would like to be on the positive side of things.
Correct. Thank you on that note. Thanks for joining us, and thank you to Nigel as well for prepping us for what to expect from the cement sector. Strong quarter expected. But CSB Bank just came out.